Good evening for WRCO News. I'm Joanne Krulatz. There have been 72 wildfires across Wisconsin in the past week, burning a total of 925 acres. Most of them were started by equipment like mowing operations, recreational vehicles, and more. But burning debris, even when it's been banned, has still been happening. Don't do it. One spark, even as small as a cigarette butt, can start a fire. With high winds and dry conditions, the fire danger is high for Richland and surrounding counties. However, just northeast in Juneau County and north and east of that, the fire danger is very high. We need more rain, and the drought conditions are only worsening. Currently, 64% of the state is in a drought, with 20% at severe status. UW President Jay Rothman toured UW La Crosse yesterday to hear feedback on campus needs and priorities. Rothman said the number one thing that he's heard from all UW schools is about funding from the state legislature. UW is asking for $850 million out of the state surplus funds to help balance budgets across the state. Multiple branch campuses have been closed and dozens of employees have been laid off as universities grapple with rising costs for UWL. One priority is funding the Prairie Springs Science Center. As a disaster relief volunteer working with hurricane-ravaged Florida, Green Bay real estate agent Mike Pritzel said he spends his days serving food, cleaning, and helping the residents of the shelter in any way he can.
One of the things that we're tasked with is bringing compassion and hope for these people. It's heartbreaking, but, you know, I only have one tangible skill, and that's talking. So for me, to sit down for 10, 15 minutes and just listen, put a hand on a shoulder and say, hey, we're going to do what we can, it's really fulfilling.
To discover ways you can help with disaster relief through donations, volunteering, or financial support, visit our hurricane help page at civicmedia.us/help. A traffic stop near Arena led to two people being taken into custody. Last night around 6:50, the Iowa County Sheriff's deputies conducted a traffic stop on U.S. Highway 14 and County Road C in the township of Arena. As a result of the stop, Michael B. Perkins, 46 of Muscadet, was arrested on charges of possession with intent to deliver amphetamines, resisting or obstructing an officer, possession of drug paraphernalia for the manufacture of methamphetamine, 4 counts of felony bail jumping, and possession of THC. Michelle L. Olson, 46 of Muscadet, was arrested on charges of possession of drug paraphernalia for the manufacture of methamphetamine, possession of THC, possession with intent to deliver amphetamines, resisting or obstructing an officer, and 2 counts of felony bail jumping. Perkins and Olson were transported to the Iowa County Jail, where they remain in custody. Today is the day to drop off your entries for the 2nd Annual Richland Center Pumpkin Fest. Pumpkins for competition and display can be dropped off at the courthouse lawn display area until 7 tonight. Pumpkins will be on display through Sunday, with many fun events happening throughout the weekend. You can find more information on rcchamber.org/pumpkinfest and also on the Richland Center Pumpkin Fest Facebook page. The deadline is approaching to file to fill the vacancy in Supervisory District 6 of the Richland County Board of Supervisors. Those at least 18 years of age interested in being appointed as a county board supervisor from the vacant district can submit a letter of consideration to the county clerk by 4:30 Friday. The letter should contain your name and address and a brief statement of qualifications to serve on the county board. You can submit your application or letter to derek.kalish@co.richland.wi.us. The vacancy will be filled from the list of applicants at the county board meeting Tuesday, November 19th at 7 o'clock. Nonprofit organizations, businesses, schools, and local government agencies located in and serving Richland County and its residents are eligible to apply for grant funding to support prevention, treatment, and recovery related to the opioid epidemic. Funding can be requested by completing an application and submitting it to the attention of the Director of Richland County Health and Human Services by 4:30 Monday. Applications will be reviewed at the Health and Community Services Committee meeting November 7th at 9:30. All applicants are required to be present at the meeting. A final review and approval by the Richland County Board of Supervisors will occur on December 10th. Questions regarding this grant opportunity may be directed to the HHS Director, Tricia Clements, at 608-649-5935. The Riverdale FFA will host a haunted walk at the school farm Thursday from 6:30 to 9. Enter and park through the test plot entrance. Free will donations will be accepted. Those attending are to wear closed-toed shoes. The Department of Workforce Development encourages employers to apply for the latest Wisconsin Fast Forward grant by Monday. Companies of all types and sizes across Wisconsin are eligible for the funding to train skilled workers. The Wisconsin Fast Forward program helps employers develop innovative local and regional solutions that meet their area's workforce needs. These industry sectors worker training grants reimburse customized occupational training costs for unemployed, underemployed, and existing workers. Training that qualifies workers for full-time employment, higher level employment, or increased wages can be reimbursed through grants of $5,000 to $400,000. Eligible applicants include public agencies, private organizations in all industry sectors, a consortium of placement partners with the lead public or private organization serving as the applicant, and tribal governing bodies of a federally recognized tribe or band of Native Americans, or an organization appointed by the tribal governing body. More information and instructions to apply can be found at the Wisconsin Fast Forward program. Again, the deadline to apply is 3 o'clock Monday afternoon. Consumers are gearing up to celebrate Halloween. Total Halloween spending is expected to reach $11.6 billion, according to the National Retail Federation's annual survey conducted by Prosper Insights and Analytics. 72% of people will participate in Halloween-related activities this year. Those numbers can seem daunting for a single day, especially when watching the family budget. However, there are ways to keep the fun stylish and on budget. Better Business Bureau recommends the following tips this Halloween. Look around your home. Check your closet. There are probably hidden surprises to help you throw together a killer costume. If the idea of spending money on buying a costume isn't quite appealing because you will only wear it once, consider renting. Renting a costume leaves room in the budget. Research rental companies through the Better Business Bureau at BBB.org. Check the store policy regarding trying on costumes. Inspect the condition of the outfit. And read the rental agreement carefully before signing anything. Buy in bulk. It may seem counterintuitive, but buying more can save you money. Buying in bulk lessens the cost per item. Factory wrapped candy will last a long time, even if you have leftovers. Always check the return policy. Seasonal shops carry unique items for a short period in a temporary location or online. When shopping for a seasonal vendor, understand the store's return policy before purchasing. Remember, buying a bunch of stuff with the intent of simply returning it after October 31st is considered fraud. When shopping from an online website, the first step is ensuring the URL starts with HTTPS and includes a lock symbol. The S in HTTPS stands for secure. Look up the website's privacy policy and contact information. If it is not clearly listed or they only have an email as the point of contact, take that as a big red flag and shop elsewhere. Also, be sure to use your credit card instead of your debit card, as credit cards not only provide additional protection, but also are easier to dispute a fraudulent charge. If you decide to shop from a seasonal store, ask whether or not they will be open after the holiday, how long they plan to stay open, and if they will accept returns after Halloween. If they plan to close up shop on November 1st or refuse returns after, either consider shopping elsewhere or take more time to be sure that item is exactly what you want before making the purchase. The Wisconsin Department of Natural Resources reminds all spearers interested in harvesting a lake sturgeon from Lake Winnebago during the 2025 sturgeon spearing season to buy their license by October 31st. There are an unlimited number of licenses available for Lake Winnebago, and residents and non-residents can purchase a license through the Go Wild system or at any license sales location. All license holders must be at least 12 years old. Military personnel home on leave during the spearing season and youth who will turn 12 between November 1st and the last day of the 2025 spearing season do not need to purchase their license, by the October 31st deadline. The Upriver Lakes fishery, managed by a preference point system and lottery that is limited to 500 permitted spears. Successful Upriver Lakes tag applicants have already been notified for the 2025 season and have until the start of the spearing season to purchase a license. However, successful applicants cannot also purchase a tag for Lake Winnebago. The 2025 sturgeon spearing season opens February 8th and will run for a maximum of 16 days or until any of the predetermined harvest caps are met.